What's up, YouTube? This is Nigel here. I got my trusty assistant, Miles. We don't really know where we are right now, but we're gonna go try to find some evidence that can make us find out where we are. Oh, there's a sign. Let's go check it out.
Watch out for the steps.
What the bloody hell is this? Can't really read that well, so... yeah.
We at war. We at war with terrorism, racism, but most of all, we at war with ourselves. God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down. You know what the Midwest is, young and restless, restless. Might snatch your necklace, the next deed might check.
Dornbirn, Austria, which is just across the, I think, the Rhine River from Germany. And her great-grandfather was a shopkeeper. His son, Francis Martin, didn't want to be a shopkeeper, didn't want to be a businessman, he wanted to be an artist. And in those days, you could make a good living as an artist because people had their portraits painted, as they do today, but more so then, because this is before cameras. And also, they painted in Austria.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
St. Katharine Drexel, born November 26, 1858 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Died not too far from Philadelphia in a town called Bensalem on March 3, 1955, and canonized by Pope John Paul II on October 1, 2000. Her feast day is March 3rd, the anniversary of her death.
St. Katharine Drexel dedicated herself to the needs of Native Americans and African Americans. She was an advocate for racial tolerance. She established a religious congregation, the Sisters of the Blessed Sacrament, which was a religious congregation for Native Americans and black people. There are 7 schools attributed to St. Katharine Drexel. St. Katharine Drexel School in Montana, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, and Chester, Louisiana, Minnesota, and South Dakota. Here we have an original habit worn by St. Katharine Drexel, including her shoes that she wore for more than 10 years.
Right here we have the Mother Catherine's kneeler and chair. It's pretty nice. It's pretty antique, if you know what I mean. So, yep, it is.
Here we have St. Katharine's desk, given to her by Monsignor Joseph Stefan. Also her wheelchair that she started using after her career-ending heart attack that forced her to retire.
Oh, this is the chapel here. It's very magnificent, very quiet, so...
God, my God, I cry out, your beloved needs you. God be near, calm my fear, and take my doubt. Your kindnesses repose me up. Your love is all that draws. God, my God, let mercy sing. Amen.